Welcome back. End of this video, you will able to explain what is a variable in C and C++, and you will also will be able to explain what is a reference variable. So there is a small difference between a variable in C and C++. So you are going to understand what is going to be the difference. And moreover, in C++, we have a special reference to the variable, and we call it as reference variable. So let us see in detail. So if you take a variable in C, that should be declared at the beginning of the program. So this is what we studied all these days. Whereas in C++, variables can be declared anywhere inside a function, and it is not necessarily that you have to define, you have to declare at the beginning of the program. So let us see an example. So you can see a C++ program. It starts with the void main. We have declared two variables n and n1 and n2. So which we are going to read the values. So look at the next statement. The sum, it's a variable which we declared not in the beginning. This is declared in the middle of the program. So this is what it makes a difference, or which is going to make a difference between C and C++. Your sum is defined, which is declared in the middle of the program. So this cannot be done in case of C. So next you are going to find the sum of n1 and n2, and which will be assigned to sum, and you are going to print this. So this is all about variable. Let me repeat. There is a small difference between a variable in C and C++. In C, this should be declared at the beginning, but in C++, it should be declared anywhere inside the function. It's not necessary. It should be done at the beginning. Next is reference variable. So reference variable is same as a normal variable. We can say that which is going to give a reference to the existing variable. So think that you have got a variable called, we'll take it as x. For x, I'm going to have one more reference, and that reference is going to be the reference variable. So here, the original variable and reference variable shares the same memory location. So let us see what is the syntax for this. So you have to give the data type. First thing should be the data type. Then you have to give the ampersand reference variable name. This is equal to what is the variable, or which is a variable for which you are going to have a reference variable, or we call it as the existing variable. Let me repeat. So this data type can be any primitive data type like int, float, character. Then you have to give the ampersand reference variable. Think that I'm going to take the reference variable as a. So where you can assign the existing variable, will let us take it as b. So now what happens? A is an existing, sorry, b is an existing variable. For that we have a reference called a. So let us see another example. So we have taken a variable called total, which is assigned a value 100. Now we have taken a reference for that. The reference for total is going to be sum. Look at how it is done. This is a data type. This is the ampersand. This is a reference variable name, and this is the existing variable. So now what happens? The total and sum has got the same memory location. whether you print the total or sum, both are going to give the equal value, and which is going to be 100. So let me make it clear. If we take the total or sum, both has got the same value. And please do remember, they share the same memory location. The reference variable and existing variable shares the same memory location. Your reference variable will not get a separate memory. So let us see a detailed program for this. So we have taken, as usual, it starts with the void main, and we have taken a variable x, and we print. So when I print it, I'll be getting the output as 10. Look at the next. We have taken x. X is going to get a reference variable, so which we have taken it as I reference. And once it is assigned, at this stage, I reference will have a value 10, because x and I reference get the same value. Now look at the next statement, where I'm going to change the value of I reference. So at this stage, what happens? So think that this is 10. So your x is going to be this. At the same time, you will have another variable. We'll call it as I reference. So this is your I reference. So both have the same value, and both has got the same memory location. Now what I do is, I'm going to change this I reference. I reference from 20 to, sorry, from 10 to 20. So this is going to be 20. Next, I'm going to print x value. Now what is x? X is going to be 20. Next, I'll increment x. So whether I increment x or I reference, which is going to have the same impact. So this is going to be 20 plus 1, which is 21. So when I print, whether I increment x or I reference, in both the way, this value get incremented, and which is going to print 21. So let me make it clear. If you look at the previous statement where I have made I reference, see here, I reference is a reference to x. Please make it very clear. I reference and x have separate entries in the OS, but still the address is going to remain same. Even though they are separate entities, but they are going to share the same memory location. So what happened? The change in the value of x is going to reflect in the value of I reference. Same way, if you make changes in the value of I reference, which is going to reflect in x. So the main thing about this is, when you declare a reference variable, that must be initialized. It's mandatory that you have to initialize. And the value of I reference can be read the same way you read the value of an ordinary variable. There is no difference. So let us see another example where we are going to read the value of I reference. So we have taken again two variables. One is x, other one is y. So we have taken x is equal to 10, and we have got a reference for this. Then this reference we are assigning to y. Now what happens? So this is going to be your x. This is going to be your I reference. Both are 10. Now look at this. We have taken a normal variable. Please remember, y is a normal variable where you have assigned what is there in I reference, which is 10. Look at the next statement. We are going to print the y value. What is there in y, which is 10. You are going to increment y. That means only y you are going to increment. So y plus plus. So this is going to be 10 plus 1, which is 11. Next, you are going to print x. So x remain as it is, and y is going to be 11. So this is a way we are going to read the value of a reference variable. So let me make it clear. So when I print the values, so the first value is going to be y. Y gets the value of I reference. So I reference was 10. So this is going to be 10. Then I increment y value. So let me draw it again. So this is what my y. This is what my x. At the same time, I'll just write it as I reference. So initially this is 10. So x is 10 and I reference is also 10. So what is y? Y is I reference, which is nothing but your y also going to be 10. Next, you're going to print the y value, which is 10. Look at, I'm going to increment the y by 1. So y is going to be 10 plus 1. Right? C out x, you're going to print the x value. So what is there in x? Which is 10. So you'll be getting, or which is going to print 10 as the output. And you're going to print I reference value. What is I reference? I reference also 10. And what is going to be the y value? Y is 10 plus 1, which is 11. So we got output as 10, 10, 10, and 11. So we, if you want, we can use a reference variable as a function argument. So let us see how we can do this. So look at the program. We have taken a variable called x. So let me draw here. So this is going to be your x, which is 10. So I hope you understood the statement. Next, we have increment x. So this is 10. And obviously it will come to the function definition. So now what happens, r? This is, r is not a normal variable. It's a reference for x. So now what happens, both r and x has got the same address. What does it mean? R is a reference for the variable x. Now what I do is I'll increment this r. So when I increment this r, what happens? Even the x gets incremented. Look at this. So finally you are going to print your x value. So when I print x, what happened? X also got changed. In fact, I have not incremented x directly. I have incremented x through its reference. So when its reference got incremented, even x value got changed. So your output is going to be 11. Right? So next is how we can return the references. So let us see how we can do it. So let us see the program. So you can see again we have taken, you know, two variables. One is x, other one is y. So let me take x. So this is going to be my x and this is going to be y. And what it says, x is 10 and y is 20. Right. Now, so we have taken a reference variable called r. R is not a normal variable, it's a reference variable. So which is, we are going to pass x and y. So now what happens, this is, what is going to be a? A is going to be a reference for x. Look at this. What is b? B is going to be a reference for y. Let me repeat. A is a reference for x, sorry, not for y. A is a reference for x and b is a reference for y. So obviously it will come to the function definition. So we have got the references. Next, if a greater than b, whether a is greater than b, a is 10 and b is 20, so this condition fails. Else, return b. What is your b? B is 20. So b is 20. So this will be returned to r. Now what is r? R is also a reference to b. At the same time, R is also has got the same value as your y and b, right? So in this case, your R is a reference. Now what we do is we are going to change this value. R is minus 1. That means we are going to raise this, and where we are going to write the value as minus 1, right? So next you are going to print x value. What is x? X is 10. You are going to print y. What is there in y? Which is minus 1. So we got it. So a and x refers to the same memory location, and y and b refers to the same memory location. So please understand this. So this is all about the reference variable and normal variable.